Alright, hello everyone. Welcome back to Armored Core. I am SIMSteven, also known as Mr. Fenral. Okay, before we get going today on the last five missions, and hopefully we'll get all five of them done today, and this Let's Play, I'm going to buy a couple pieces of equipment before we get going. Now, I've done this mission a few times, and this mission has been causing me more trouble than Nineball has. So I've got a plan in mind this time around. I'm going to change some parts up, and we're going to go with this. I'm going to buy this FCS and a dual missile. Now, what a dual missile does in comparison to a regular missile launcher is it shoots two missiles at once, and well, this will be a nice thing to have for what's coming up in the next mission, because what's going to happen is we're going to be fighting a lot of airplanes. And if you remember back towards the beginning of the Let's Play when we did the mission, when we defended the train while it does a refuel at a supply depot, you might have remembered we fought some airplanes that pretty much were a pain to get a lock on. And so we're going to be fighting a lot of those things. Plus, at the same time, we're going to be doing it on a blimp in the middle of the air. And this mission sucks. It really does. It's either it cheats, as you might want to think of it, or it's just very, very poorly coded. Now, the reason why this mission is such a pain is, think of if you're driving along on a highway and a bug flies in your windshields and splatters. This is kind of the same situation that we have here, only instead of the bug splattering, it just kind of hangs there for a minute and then just flies off and it's fine and dandy. Nothing happens. It doesn't die, doesn't splatter. Well, that's kind of why I'm saying this mission is very poorly coded, because we're going to be fighting a bunch of those stealth airplanes, and they kind of come in, and I think their AI is programmed to always try and fly behind your AC, and with the way mine is set up right now, with the legs and all, I have a very bad turning speed, and I don't think I can really improve that without really doing a whole overhaul of my AC, so I'm just going to buy these two parts and hope that it works pretty well, which I've already tested it once off screen, so it should be alright. But get used to me trying to just get a good look and a good lock on these airplanes, because this is a real pain of a mission to do because of how fast they fly and how quick I need to be able to turn, but I can't, and so I'm going to have to really just try and get a good lock on these airplanes. Plus, with the whole windshield bug in the LG, they're often gonna fly into the side of this blimp, as you see on the screen, and they'll just kinda get stuck there for a little bit, and then they're just gonna slide off real fast, and it's a pain to really get a good lock. Plus, not only in addition to all that, but their shots tend to force you downwards, and we're going to be fighting in midair. So if I get shot at a lot, I might end up falling off the map, because you got to get vertical height if you're getting too far down below. And so it's either I'm going to have to stay on the ground or on the top of the blimp and just kind of not fly up at all, or I'm going to fly up and try to get a good lock on these things. So it's either pick your poison on how we're going to do this mission. So yeah, I've been having a lot of problems with this one, in addition to the fact that it also has turrets, friendly turrets on the blimp, and the turrets are going to throw me off because they also show up on my radar, and it'll be a hard time trying to even find these little airplanes. But enough ranting aside, we're going to read the mission debriefing and we're going to get on with this. And hopefully we're going to complete this mission, because it's been causing me more trouble, like I said, than Nineball did. This is going to be, what, my fourth attempt at completing this mission. So here we go. Recently, our transport blimps have been attacked one after another. We don't know what they want, but the blimp is always shut down, so the target is probably not the payload. Perhaps they are simply intending to interrupt our operations at someone's instigation. We could provide full-scale escorts, but this risks marring our reputation. These incidents have not gotten out to the public, so we want you to ride secretly in the blimp and repulse the attacking group. Note that we expect the battle to be fought on the blimp, so be careful not to fall. Yeah, that happened to me once, because I was trying to fly up and shoot down these planes. Then I got shot at a bunch, and, well, not a fun time, and I fell off the map. So, yeah, be aware of that. But we're going to shut up, and I'm going to shut up ranting and all that, and we're going to get on with this mission.
Main system engaging combat mode.
This is the captain speaking. Unidentified craft are approaching. I think it's them. Go get them.
Bridge has been damaged. You must destroy them all without delay.
Target of operation cleared. System switched to normal mode.
Oh boy, that was a lot easier now that I changed my gear for that. Hopefully you don't have as much problems as I did with this the first few times, but I came up with a strategy of success, apparently, because, you could probably tell that I didn't really have any... Well, it wasn't a problem for me dying or anything, so I didn't really have to worry about my own AC. It's just the whole blimp getting destroyed. I mean, half the time I couldn't even see where the airplanes were, and I still lost, like, a good chunk of the ship. It got damaged, even though we really didn't see where they were half the time. And I'm pretty sure you just have to wait out that mission for a while, but Yeah, without those missiles and that FCS, I was having a really long time getting a good lock on these enemies here. So, yeah, we're through with that mission, and I'm going to put my stuff back the way it was. Yeah, in one of the attempts, I tried this FCS, which I think we got on one of the missions. And I used, what was the other missile launcher? We had one missile launcher. I think it was this one. I think we picked this up in a mission as well. And I just attempted to use what I had. But unfortunately, it did not work out very well. Because when I tried that FCS and missile launcher combination, it was taking like 3 seconds to get a good lock on. And as you saw when I did the mission just there, it took, I had a hard time getting a shot off even with like 1 second lock ons. So yeah, I guess that's kind of how I guess I just needed a faster lock on and better missiles and ones that did more damage, which is why I went with that dual missile launcher. So yeah. Anyways, rant over. I just hope you don't get that as your only option of a mission if you're playing through the game and haven't beaten it yet. So, yeah, that was a pain. We got these two close together. And we got this one. You know what? Let's rescue a transport truck. We lost communications with one of our transport trucks heading for Avalon Valley, somewhere near Nassau Tunnel. We strongly believe this was an act of a terrorist group targeting the advanced chemical weapons loaded on the truck. If this is true, we cannot leave this up to the guards. Go to Elite ASAP and search for the truck. Eliminate anyone who interferes. Safety of the vehicle is the most priority. Don't want to get this. Blah, 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 blah. One more thing. Inefficient civilian vehicles may be traveling the site. If you destroy the vehicles, compensation for damage will be deducted for your pay. So we gotta pay their insurance. Alright, so yeah. Anyways, we're gonna get this going. Oh, and by the way, I may have to do this in 2 recording sessions because apparently, I don't know if you can hear it through the mic right now because it has good noise cancellation for the background and all that. But I think I hear thunder, and I may need to do this in 2 recordings because, well, thunderstorms and electronics don't really mix very well. Anywho, we're going to finish this mission real quick. I think this is one that is real quick, and then we'll keep going.
Main system engaging combat mode.
The truck's load is poison gas. Avoid hitting gas canisters if you find them.
Enemy reinforcements approaching. Two of the same type. Target of operation cleared. System switched to normal mode.
Alright, that was short and sweet. And, well, pretty minimal rewards. We was probably meant to do that pretty early in the game. But we're just gonna save as per usual. And we're at 92%, so we're almost done. Alright, and I really hope I can get overweight mode without that radar, but then I'm probably gonna have to take it anyways. You know what? I think once I get to like 100% or all the missions done, I might make 2 separate save files where I get that radar and one where I don't. So I have my perfect 100% completion and then I have my perfect 100% success rate ratio. Alright, so what else have we got? We got those two. We might do those together in a batch. But we're going to get this one. I think this is the last one at the bottom here. Yep. And then we'll take care of those two later. And this is why I'm saying I hope we get all these done in one episode. Actually, I might make this episode extra long just in case we don't get like one done before the end. Because, well, yeah. Let's make this our last episode. And, well, like I said before, I don't know how long these missions are. I just don't really remember a lot of these missions anymore. Anyways, decided to carry out an operation intended to occupy the Murakumo's base of activities. Space Station Cade. Since our ship attack failed the other day, the pace of Murakumo's activities in space have picked up extraordinarily. Large amounts of material have been carried out to space, and Cade is rapidly becoming a fortress. If we leave this as is, it will only become more difficult to act later. Our first division has already begun fighting mission to support invasion troops, bring material to the supply vehicles to engage in combat. I don't remember this. enemy forces are more numerous than expected, and supply material may not be in time. And it's... Hey guys, it's spelled M-A-T-E-R-I-A-L. Material, not L. Anyways, grammar Nazi aside. Place material in the catapult. Capture the catapult and pass material in the supply corps. Murakumo's plans have been in space. Stopping for tonight. Okay. I'm just gonna wing it. I'm running out of patience with some of these, but yeah, that first mission still getting on my nerves.
Main system engaging combat mode.
Raven, our troops have already begun fighting inside. Move in while supporting them.
Gate check. Cannot unlock gate. 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 Target object obtained. Gate check. Cannot unlock gate. Gate check. Cannot unlock gate.
Good work. Leave the rest to us.
Target of operation cleared. System switched to normal mode.
Alright, I guess the point of that mission was just to figure out where the frick I need to go. Alright, well, I'm hearing a lot of thunder outside, so I'm going to take a break and... we're going to save real quick, and we're going to take care of those last two missions that are right next together after a bit of a brief cut. And then I'll be back to finish the rest of this Let's Play and put it all in one episode. Alright, and I am back. It's actually been about 3 days or so since I did the last couple missions. And actually, the thunderstorm has passed because I stopped recording since, you know, thunderstorms and computers don't mix very well. So I just kind of played my 3DS in bed for the rest of the day. we have made a couple changes. Well, actually, I think I've only made one change since I took a break. I went to the shop and checked the... out all the optional parts. I ended up buying them all just to have them all. But I made one real quick change. I had this equipped before, and I think that only really affects missiles. And since I don't have missiles anymore, I'm going to switch that over for this one, which increases my energy output, which I believe gives me a bigger energy bar for more boost and more usage of energy weapons. I believe that's what this does. And I also bought these various missile things. They were kind of cheap and they're optional parts, and so now I have all the optional parts from the shop. Probably the only one I might actually add to my setup once I get overweight mode is going to be this missile lock-on interference device. I believe it sends a pulse every few seconds that it disables lock-ons from missiles. That'll probably come in handy in the future games, but for now, we've got these last two missions to work on. And let's see here. I'm pretty sure they're both by Chrome, since we've pretty much done everything by the Murakumo side of things. So we're going to finish up these last two missions, and we'll call it the end of a Let's Play. All right. We want you to break in the space station Cade, owned by Murakumo. I think we were just there in the last mission. So I guess this was what we were supposed to do before to learn the layout of this place for that one where I just kind of stumbled about until I figured out how to beat the mission. No idea what I had to do. I tried shooting a little trailer, and apparently that was the wrong thing to do. So I'm pretty sure once I saw that little object that I picked up that I had to take it back to him. So yeah, anyways, debriefing. Your goal, destroy the new catapult. Their space station has been unmanned since the Great Destruction and was left in orbit, but Murakumo has made secret modifications, turning into a secret base. Discovered that Murakumo has sent large amounts of material to the space station. Again, material is spelled M-A-T-E-R-I-A-L. It's kind of like me in college. I kind of used to spell college as C-O-L-L-A-G-E. It's not a collage, it's college with an E-G-E. And again, we all make mistakes, but this is a professional thing. You'd think they'd spell check. but we discovered that Murakumo sent large amounts of material to the space station, and the catapult appears to be used to send material elsewhere. Still don't know what they're up to, but still, it is in space. It may be too late if we wait until the whole story is known. Space shuttle is ready. Go to the space station ASAP. We're counting on you. Alright. So, counting on me to shut up. So, let's get this going.
Main system engaging combat mode.
Intruders found in facility. Security personnel, move to intercept.
Gate check. Cannot unlock gate. Gate check. Cannot unlock gate. Gate check. Cannot unlock gate. Emergency call received. Opening emergency channel.
Shuttle speaking. Emergency. A Murakumo battleship is approaching. Halt operations. You have 3 minutes. Return immediately. I repeat, return immediately.
Combat target changed. Countdown initiated.
Maven, there's no time. Hurry.
Gate check. Cannot unlock gate. Target of operation cleared. System switched to normal mode.
Okay, if you couldn't tell, I actually knew what I was doing there. Simply because, well, I failed this mission 3 times. Editing magic for the win, I suppose. So, essentially what you need to do is not go upstairs like I did, but I did it for the special edition bonus. But, essentially all you gotta do is kind of go to the left, and then kind of when you hear the announcement saying, you know, you gotta get out of here, you should actually just go straight and then go back around to the exit and pretty much just loop around. But seeing as this was my 3rd time in the mission, I figured I'd try and speed run this thing and kill as many as I can to get that reward, that extra reward at the very end. So, the first couple times I'm like, what the frick am I supposed to do? And I was looking all around the upstairs area and I found nothing. I actually had to look it up. So, yeah. Anywho, saving the game. And we're going to finish the last final mission. And with that, we'll be, well, one slight detour short of finishing this entire Let's Play. But we'll have all the missions done. And, well, I think we gotta be in the same area because it looked like almost the same mission name here. Base generator. Is this the same place or not? I'm not entirely sure. No. This looks like that mission with all the ventilation shafts where we had to go into the ceiling to get the, that double shoulder, missile launcher. And we had to find that gas tank, and it was a very hard way to find that thing or whatever. I don't know. That looks like what the map looks like. Head for the lunar base, Roa. Roa has been unmanned and abandoned for a long time, but Murakumo has already dispatched forces tending to revive the base facilities. There are now no other usable lunar bases, so Roa is effectively the key to control the entire moon, but a full frontal attack deals a severe blow to the base itself. So this is our request. We want you to infiltrate the base alone, destroy the generator, main force, and then retake the base in confusion. Do not bother unnecessarily with enemies, but remaining UCs will be troublesome in the future, so try to destroy them on site. Will be okay, so we got a few ACs to kill on this mission. Reward me for extra kills, yada yada yada. Miracle is key to the general plot, destroys them clear, and it's written in, stop nothing, blah 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 blah. Alright, so, I think it's clear enough. We gotta destroy the generator and any ACs and other enemies.
Main system engaging combat mode.
Attention intruders, this facility is Murakumo property. Leave immediately. Anyone disobeying will be shot. I repeat, leave immediately.
No.
Emergency! Emergency! Trouble in generator room. This facility will self-destruct in 2 minutes to maintain secrecy. All workers evacuate immediately. Raven, call off the attack. Quickly return to the shuttle.
Operation cleared. System switched to normal mode.
Alright. It was kind of scary at the end with the 2 minute time limit to get out, but I remembered the path I used to get out, and I just retraced my steps. So, we finally finished all 40 some odd missions or so. Maybe that's 50, but who's counting really? Well, I guess the game is, if you... Actually, hold on. Go back. I guess the game is counting if you look at this screen. But then again, I fought that one red AC a couple times. So that, I think that counts up as well. In that one last arena mission that comes in once you beat all the missions. That's the one I'm referring to. But, as you can see, we don't have 100% just yet. And even though I've got 47 successes out of 47 sorties, sortie is when you go out on a mission, I suppose. Something like that. But we got that one last 4%. And I saved my game there for a very specific reason. But I want to really check. I want to check something really, really, really quick. We got that one last part that's in one of the missions, and let's see here. Can I switch over to my other core, the special one that I wanted to be using all this time? I'm gonna make myself overweight real quick because we gotta go and get that one last. AC part for when we guard the warehouse. Top of the list, and well, I believe that's the one right there. I'm just gonna make one final check to make sure I got a little star on everything. And we do. Alright, so we're gonna go back to here, and I want to try and do this here. See if it'll let me use overweight mode. So we've done this already, and we're supposed to guard that one part here. And woohoo, it let me in. We've done it, guys. We have attained overweight mode. So, ooh, the possibilities.
Main system engaging combat mode.
But first, we're going to destroy our career.
Enemy fighters approaching. Number of planes, 5.
I think we just need to bust into... No, not that one. Is it this one? There we are. So it's right behind where you start.
Was obtained. Breach of contract. Combat operations halted.
And you automatically fail the mission because, well, breach of contract, as my comm said. So yeah, we have to purposely fail that mission in order to get our last AC part. And, well... I think what I'm actually going to do here now is not save the game, but... Wait, what? I'm missing 2%. What did I miss? You know what? Hold on a second. I'll get back to that thought in just a second. Okay, that's a bit of a mistake on my part. I thought I had every single part in the game, or the hidden parts. So let's just backtrack a little bit. What I was going to say before I cut out there, what I planned on doing was having one save file where I have 100% completion. And I'll have another save file where I have not 100% completion, but I have all the... Well, I have my perfect win record, I suppose, or perfect success ratio. And not have that one last raider part. But, silly me, I am missing a part. Now, I think in order to get 100%, actually, when I was looking this up, I actually know this. You have to beat Nine Ball both times in the final mission, and you have to beat any optional AC that are in each and every one of the, any of the missions. Destroy all the ACs, get them on the list, I kind of already gone over this before, and get all the hidden parts, and complete all the missions. So that's all you really need to do to get 100%. I am missing one hidden part, which... I must have glossed over. I think I actually did this mission back when, like, the first mission of an episode. I completely forgot that, or completely glossed over the fact that this has a hidden part in it. Now, I remember this one where we're in this big shaft above a big lava pit, and there's only a couple of MTs that are in here. Well, apparently, this is the mission that has... a flamethrower weapon just kind of right next to where we start, and it said in my guide, which I've already done the research ahead of time, so yeah, it says that we have to just take a turn to the left.
Main system engaging combat
and it'll be
mode.
Just under where we start. So I'm guessing there's a hole in the wall here. Oh, I see it already. Okay. Oh, get back up there. Get back up there. Get back up there. Okay. Hey. I said get in the hole. Okay, there we go. Sound like I'm playing golf or something.
AC weapon obtained.
So apparently this is a flamethrower for the main hand. I'm probably not going to replace my Karasawa anytime soon. But that should be the last 2% that I was missing. Okay. And we're just going to gung-ho this. Charge! Alright. Yep. Got you. You're dead. Apparently we only had 6 ACs. Give my moonlight a little bit more time in the light. The limelight, I should say. Alright. You're dead. I'm taking a lot of damage, but I don't care. I've already beaten everything. So, yeah. Camera, please cooperate. There we go. That's two. And there's one. Are you above me or are you below me? I forget if yellow dots are above or below. I think it's below because I don't see him on my radar anymore. So he must be way down here. This is kind of why I don't do commentary when I'm doing a mission, because it's random thoughts that I don't really have. I lose the train of thought all the time. I just gotta focus. There we are. Sit down, not drop down in the lava. And boom, you're dead.
Target of operation cleared. System switched to normal mode.
And it's all a rumbly. Okay, so that should be 100% now that we've done that. I completely forgot to get this part, or just didn't even realize there was a part in that mission when I was going through and doing it the first time around. So, that should be all of it. And if we go in the system, it should say 100%. Yes, that is overall 100%. And one failure for that radar part. So, I think I'm not going to say it right now. I am probably just going to do a little bit of off-screen preparation for Project Phantasma when we get into it. But I am going to just muck around with my AC parts right now before we end off the Let's Play, because, well, there's nothing really left for us to do except show off a few things here and there. Why is it loading so slow? Scroll down, please. Okay. It's going very slow with the scrolling. So, I suppose before I started this part, I had already looked in the shop just a little bit. It's one of the things I was doing before I bought all those optional parts. And I decided I wanted to buy this leg part because, as I've said a few times throughout the course of this Let's Play, I prefer reverse joint legs over humanoid and the four-leggers and the tank dreads. But I haven't really used them at all because, just compare the max weight on this. This is 7,100 versus 3,990. Yeah, you can't really put a whole lot on these legs. There is a leg part in Armored Core 2 that I like to use, and I do have an optimal setup when I go through that game, which I do remember my optimal setup. when I play through that game, and that's even before I get overweight mode in Armored Core 2. But I'm gonna AC test real quick, and I'll just show you a big difference. Well, how big of a difference it makes when you equip a much faster leg part. And I looked at all of the reverse joint legs that are in the shop right now. And I think the max weight, the maximum max weight on
main system,
the reverse joint legs is only like 5,000. It is in the 5,000s, whereas the ones I've been using up to this point have been 7,000. So we killed one, and you can kind of see I can move a lot faster with these legs. Yeah, even my turning speed is a little bit better. So yeah, that's just one of the fun things about having overweight mode. If you get to customize to your heart's content, you don't even have
Target
to worry
demolished.
About
Halting
like
test mode.
The energy requirements, because that's based on your generator or your arm weight limit, I believe, which is based on your core weight limit. So yeah, you don't have to worry about any of that. And I'm pretty sure, well, as we proved, all you have to do is beat every mission and then you unlock overweight mode. I don't believe you need 100% completion in order to get it. But we got this now, and can I equip this? Yes, we've got our optimal setup. Well, kind of, sort of. There are a few things that I want, but you know, we've got two whole game expansions ahead of us. And this was back in the old days when you couldn't just download a patch because, well, the PlayStation 1 did not have internet capabilities, so you couldn't, like, download a patch and get all of Armored Core Project Phantasma. No, you had to buy a whole another game if you wanted to have the expansion pack to Armored Core, which, in my opinion, Armored Core Project Phantasma is the first real Armored Core game, not this one. There is something that is severely lacking from the original Armored Core, and that is the arena system. And Project Phantasma is the first game that really introduces that. And then, well, naturally, Armored Core Master Z the Arena really drives home the whole arena system, and from then on, I believe every single Armored Core game has arenas. Although I think Another Age doesn't have the arena. I think it's Another Age is, well, it's expansion to Armored Core 2. But I don't think Another Age has arenas. I think it's just an entire mission expansion pack, and that's it. Granted, it's a really fun expansion pack, and there's lots of good missions in there, as well as a returning familiar face from this game. I won't spoil it too terribly much, but there is a returning AC from this game that reappears in Another Age. But yeah, the arena becomes more of a staple of the series, starting with the very next game that we're going to be doing a Let's Play of. And so I'm going to play through that. Well, we're not even going to even interrupt the schedule, aside from the fact that, well, I've got to redo getting that flamethrower part in my other file, and I'll make two separate save files, and I'm probably going to just muck around a little bit with the transfer mechanics to see if I got my information straight. But speaking of transferring to Project Phantasma, I believe all the items that are currently in the shop will still be there, so anything we have not yet bought, we can still buy in the later games. There have been playthroughs in the past where I simply just farmed, you know, the very last mission, the AC battle, and just killed that guy in like 5 seconds flat over and over and over again, and farmed money and bought everything out of the shop, and it just kind of made money useless from this point on. Now, I don't know if all the parts will be available from the shop from the very beginning. I'm pretty sure the hidden parts are not in the shop. I believe you have to find them here in Armored Core 1, or else they're lost in the next few games. The next two games, I should say. There's no third game. But I believe everything you can buy here is going to, well, actually, scratch that. I'm pretty sure we had an email or two where it said, more parts in the shop after you, yeah, new parts added after you beat a couple missions here in this game. So I don't know if those parts will be available either. All the standard parts that are there from the very beginning of the game when you first start a new game should be in the shop once we transfer to Project Phantasma. I just don't know if the ones that are unlocked will still be there or not. But since we're transferring, they should still be there. I believe if you don't do a transfer file and just start a new game fresh in Project Phantasma. That's the area where it's kind of a gray area for me, and I'm just a little bit unclear. But there is one thing that I know that does not, that you cannot get whatsoever, that even at this point in time in the game, I believe if you go 50,000 credits into debt, you cannot do Human Plus mode after beating the game. So you gotta make sure you do that here in Armored Core 1, and I don't believe it even works in Project Phantasma and Mastered Arena. You gotta do it here in this game, otherwise you will not have Human Plus mode. Same thing with Overweight mode. You cannot unlock Overweight mode normally. I mean, you can probably do it with a Game Shark, but I don't believe you can unlock Overweight mode in Project Phantasma or Armored Core or Mastered Arena. It has to be done in this game, and it has to be transferred over to the other games. Otherwise, you'll not be able to get these features. Fortunately for us, I've done it, and we're going to be transferring those features in. And we're really going to play around with the beauty of what makes Armored Core so special, and that is just customization to your heart's extent. And this was kind of my plan all along. I mean, I just wanted to get through all the missions in this game. You know, provide goods, you know, a good setup, and then you could just run with it if you're playing along. But when we get into Project Phantasma, we're really gonna spend our money and buy lots of fun stuff. Like I said before several times, I've been wanting to use this thing here, this grenade launcher. Not bought a single one of these, and I really want to use one a few times, because this thing packs a wall up. It's one of the strongest weapons in the entire game, like my my plasma cannon that I've been using. Let's see here, where are you? This one here. That one I've been using that just completely wrecks ACs and missions, yeah. I believe the grenade launcher is even more powerful, even though it shoots a little bit slower, so yeah, very good weapon, just have not had a chance to show it off, but if you stay tuned to Project Phantasma, we'll be using it. what else do I have to say? Something I wanted to talk about when we completed the game, the story of Armored Core, you know, after we defeated Nineball. I just kind of want to talk about, you know, the story of Armored Core in general, because now that we've been through this game and kind of seen, you know, that story is really not up there on the priority list of what the developers were going for in this game. And really, this is not like a big RPG like a Final Fantasy game. This is just a game to play for gameplay. I'd probably compare Armored Core to like classic Mega Man or the Mega Man X series, because pretty much those games, they give you a simple setup to the plot, a simple ending to the plot, but the entire rest of the game is about the gameplay, and screw all the minor details in between. That's kind of the same thing that Armored Core has going for it. It's all about the gameplay, it's all about customizing your mech to whatever you like to have it do for you. And then you just go off and complete missions, complete stages, make some money, and then you can customize yourself even more from that point on. And just have some fun blowing the crap out of things. That's really the heart and soul of Armored Core. Similar to how the original Mega Mans, they had a very bare-bones story, and they pretty much all ended the same, too. They had the same ending, you know, like classic Mega Man games. You pretty much go in. Wily has a plot that he's concocted. He has 8 robot masters. You go in, defeat them all, and then you go destroy Wily's castle, and Wily has been thwarted. That's kind of how Armored Core is, even with like the endings of Armored Core. I mean, yeah, 2 corporations always going after each other's throats, and in the end, they destroy each other, and plot-wise, there's really not much more beyond that. I mean, you become the number one Raven, and this really powerful person who is the best mercenary out of everyone that's really the plot of all the Armored Core games, at least the ones that I played, and I played all the way up through Armored Core 3. So, yeah, that's just kind of some final words I have to say about, you know, Armored Core. So, really, if we talk about plot in the future Let's Plays of this series, the plot really doesn't matter, is what I'm saying. I mean, it's pretty much going to be the same thing. We already know what to expect because of what I've done here in this Let's Play. I mean, it's pretty much going to be the same. But anyways, I suppose that's it for parting words. Get ready for Project Phantasma. We're going to play through that next, and we're just going to continue with the original Armored Core series. And then we're going to head into the PlayStation 2. By then, I should be done with Grandia. I should be done with Suikoden 2 by the time we finish Master's Arena. And hopefully we'll move on to the PlayStation 2 Let's Plays that I want to do once we've got these three series done. Which is kind of why I'm going to focus heavily on Armored Core, because we got two games to go through. And even though it took me like 11 episodes to get through Armored Core 1, Project Phantasma I don't think is a very long game. I think it's actually shorter than this, but it has the whole arena system. So, you know, it's got that going for us, and we're probably just going to destroy a lot of, you know, other ACs in the arena system. And, well, it's a ladder system. You got like 50 opponents, and then you just climb the ladder, and then you win. And it's got a few missions in it as well. Mastery Arena is all about the arena, and there's like, I think there's like 10 or 15 missions in that one. Very bare bones on the missions, but it also has two discs, so there's like one disc dedicated all to arena. So, yeah, anyways, that's what we've got to look forward to. And I guess that's all I really have to say at this point. So, this is SIMSteven, also known as MezzaFenderal, and see you guys next time for Armored Core Project Phantasma. Thanks for watching.